it's finally time to do some fiberglassing work. So last video ended by having the tunnel in place, and just to show you the just a leftover piece of tunnel. Sorry for my cabin sole, it's a bit noisy. So first step today is that we will prep the inner surface of the hole and the just to clean up the tunnel again. Then I will put in a very big fillet around using the epoxy and the 4 of 2 to create the nice round. And while that's still uncured, we're gonna do the wet layup. Then we will start adding the fiberglass strips. And I am using a 300 gram biaxial. You have top layer of fiberglass in one direction, the other one in the negative 45. So you have a 90 degree pattern. So I will lay up these strips here. That's gonna be a total of 10 layers on the inside and 3 layers on the outside. It's gonna be a extremely strong laminate here. Sidepower recommend you have 8 layers alternating between the normal chop strand mat and the rowing, which is normally used in when you do a polyester laminate. So this will far exceed what they recommend. So that's good. So we hopefully look in the sink to do that. Please follow along. It's gonna be very interesting. Finally, the spring is here. It's getting warmer. And start putting the boat back together so we can hopefully have it in the water within hopefully a few weeks. So if you haven't done already, please subscribe to the channel. And if you like the video, please give a thumbs up. So this is where we're at. So we got 3 full rounds here, and we got 1.5 the road up here. You see, I put in peel ply when I finished last night. And peel ply is super important because it's going to, basically you don't have to sand everything again before you do the next layer. It leaves like this nice super textured surface that's where the next layer is going to adhere to very well. So that's good. To prepare for tying in the inner hole with the exterior hole, I need to fill in the gap up here. And this is going to be a bit of a experiment. So I'm just going to try using this expanding PU foam. And it's not intended to be like any kind of structural, it's just gonna be giving me like a backer to put on the fiberglass laminate, tying from the side. and then coming down to the inner hole.
Okay, fingers crossed.
Okay, so you saw the foam part that turned out to be a complete disaster. I thought I could somehow defy gravity, which I couldn't. So I had to redo it off camera. And what I did is that I took masking tape and I basically taped down here to tape the shape. And then I filled in the foam behind the tape. I let it sit for a few days, took the foam off, sanded it down. So now we have like this nice taper all the way around. And then I have been putting a bit of thickened epoxy in those spots where there were some low spots. So now we are ready to continue with the glassing of the tunnel. We are at 8 layers on the starboard side and 3 layers on the port side. And we're going to go at 10 layers, even though Sidepower, they suggested we should have about 8 layers. Let's go for 10. And then we will also start doing the covering the connection between the inner hole and the exterior hole. So yes, I know that we're still in the episode of the fiberglassing, but since the nice winter in Denmark suddenly hit, it's getting a bit too cold to do the final steps of fiberglassing. That's why, just to spend time wisely, I started working on the actual technical installation. So the battery is of course going to sit out here, and I'm going to point down, and you can see down there, I'm thinking it's going to sit on this piece of 12mm plywood that I cut to shape. And basically first I just cut a cardboard template and then transfer it to this piece of plywood, and I'm gonna put it like right down here. See? So it sits of course nice and level. So the steps on installing this plate down here is going to be, I want to fiberglass this in when it gets a bit warmer, but just prepare for it. I'm going to mark the two positions here, grind off the gel coat to bare fiberglass, prepare for that, and then just to make it a bit more sturdy, I'll also cut those two pieces of also 12mm plywood. And they are going to be bolted on the bulkhead here. So I noticed this wobbling of the motor bracket when it sits on the tunnel, and it's a bit weird because this is a original side power tunnel. Has the inner diameter 125 and then a wall thickness of 4 millimeters. According to the instruction, you can go up to a wall thickness of 5 millimeter if you use a different kind of tunnel. Anyway, to fix this, because I'm not a big fan of having this this warp, because when you do the tension between the gearbox inside the tunnel and this, something has to give in, and I think the tunnel is probably the weakest point, because this motor bracket is quite sturdy design. So what I'm gonna do is that I will just put three layers of 300 gram BX on top of the tunnel out there. It should be about uncompressed thickness 1.2, but compressed, I think it will go down to about 0.8, 0.9. So imagine three layers, put the motor bracket on, and then tie it with a string from one, like around across the tunnel here. Squeeze it down tightly, and then I should be left with a nice, almost like a opposite mold of this one on top of the tunnel. Of course, I'm gonna put a piece of PE plastic, so I won't accidentally glue this one to the tunnel. So that's what I'm gonna do. So I had to do the final layup of camera. It's getting a bit messy down here with epoxy on my gloves and everywhere, so I didn't want to touch my camera. But anyway, here's the results. And of course, I put a piece of plastic underneath so it won't stick. So now this one should have a very nice and tight fit. Yes. So there's like no wobbling. Because it used the compression force with the string here to squeeze the layers together, it filled the gap. So now the motor bracket sits and conforms like exactly how it should be to the tunnel. So now that we have all the fiberglass work done on the interior of the boat, it's time to move outside. And that means first we have to trim off the excess tunnel that sticks out. I left a bit too proud just to have something to work with. So that's gonna be step one, to trim it off. Afterwards, I will make the spoiler, a small deflector, which is gonna reduce the drag when you are underway. And then I'm gonna do some fiberglass layup on that side. So it's just gonna. So what do you do for a living?
I'm a dentist.
Ah.
And I know glass fibers quite well.
So this is like shaving a tooth.
Kinda. We use it a bit differently, but still.
Have I explained you why we do this? This is to prevent like turbulence inside the tunnel and noise as well. And you're saying? Make this called a deflector or spoiler. So, how many did you cut?
I cut 6 × 16 cm, 6 × 14 cm, 6 × 12 cm.
Okay, and that's going for the exterior side of the fiberglassing, yes. Right? Okay, so we're going to start by having the longest strips.
Yeah.
So it's 6 pieces, 16.
Yeah.
And then overlapping with the 6 pieces of 14, and then 6 pieces of 12.
Exactly.
And this is all 300 gram by actual fiberglass. So let's go outside and do some
fiberglassing.
Back inside the boat, all three layers are done on the outside. So now we can conclude that the structural fiberglassing is done on the boat. So that's very good, and I can continue with the actual technical installations. So I'm going to end this video by what you just saw with the three layers on the outside, and then next video we're going to do the final fairing and the making it look nice and pretty. And that's simply to do with the amount of work that you have to do with the fairing. Is basically just have to apply one layer, and then you have to wait one day, and then you sand it, and then you do it again and again. So by doing this, I can go out, put a layer on, and work on the installations, record video for that episode, and then use the time for more wisely. So I hope you enjoyed this episode, and again, please press that subscribe button and a thumbs up if you like it, and see you soon. Bye.